Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Friends, let us see the numerical that we have considered for circular motion. This is on circular motion. A rotor has, this is a question, the rotor has a diameter of 4 meter, a rotor which rotates like a cylindrical drum. The rotor is rotated about the central vertical axis. The occupant remains pinned against the wall. When the linear velocity of the drum is 8 meter per second. So this is the velocity when the rotor rotates and the person is inside is pinned against the wall. That means it is the minimum velocity when it is not falling down. That is the minimum velocity required. Compute coefficient of static friction between the wall, because why it is not falling? Because there is a friction between the wall of the rotor and the clothing of occupant, the person's cloth and the wall. Also calculate, so you have to find the coefficient of static friction. You have to also calculate the angular velocity of the drum, with what angular velocity is rotating and how many revolutions will it make in minute. That means you have to find the frequencies. So the question, so let me just help you in the form of a diagram. The solution to this question, there is a drum here in the form of a rotor. Okay, now you can complete the circle like that, and this I will end here. I will just end here, and the person is pinned here inside. This is the person. And this is the vertical axis. This is rotating with what omega to find, and speed of the linear speed is 8 meter per second. And what is given? The diameter of this one, that is the radius, is 2 meter. Because the diameter is 4 meters. Now, as this person is rotating, this person will move in this circular path. And this is the center. So, if I have to draw a free body diagram, then the weight of the person is vertically downward. Because it wants to fall down, the friction will be in the upper direction. This is the force of friction. And it is rotating. Some centripetal force would be provided because it is pinned to the wall. So normal reaction will be in this direction towards the center of the circle. Now, because the normal reaction is inward towards the center, and this is the condition, we can write that the force of friction actually is balanced by balancing the weight, and the normal reaction is responsible for centripetal force. These are the two things that we can understand from here. That because the body, when it is attached to it and rotates and it wants to fall down, so the falling down is because of gravity, and not falling down is because the friction is opposing the motion downward. So this will balance, and normal reaction, because it is pinned against the wall, so normal reaction will be outward. The force of friction that we understand, that it is mu n. This is the coefficient of static friction, and n, this is the force of friction. I'll put here, and it is mu s n is mg, and this one is centripetal force, which is n equals to centripetal force. I'll write as mv square over r. This is v is given as 8 meter per second. If I put this value over here, then I'll just substitute this value over here. And this is mu s, n is mv square over r, which is mg. The mass is gone. Now you are left with mu s. Mu s is rg over v square. This is the working formula that we are going to use. Now I will just put those values. Mu s is rg over v square, r is 2 meter, g I will take 9.8, you can take 10 meter per second square, and v is 8 meter per second. Okay, putting those values, I'll get here 2 into 9.8 over 8 square. If I take 20, 10, this is 20, and 20 divided by 64. Or if I take this, this will be 19.6 divided by 64. If you solve that, 19.6 divided by 64, if you solve that, then you will get 0.306 and something else that we don't want. This is the coefficient of friction that you are getting. And this is unitless, so what's the number? 0.306. The first part of the answer to this question, the first part was asked to find or compute the coefficient of static friction, and that comes out to mu s. That comes out to be 0.3. Next, we're asked to find the angular velocity of the drum. Now, this drum is actually rotating about this vertical axis. The linear velocity is 8, the radius is r, so omega can be found using the relation v equals to omega r. So I'll take v equals to omega r. From here, omega will be v over r. V is 8, given as 8 meter per second, and r is 2 meter. So this is actually 4 radian per second. This omega is 4 radian per second. This is the answer to the second part of the question. What is the angular velocity? It is 4 radians per second. The next question is to find the frequency of revolutions in a minute. It asks how many revolutions will it make it in a minute. So angular velocity you have got. Next is to find the number of revolutions it will make in a minute. That means we are asked to find number of revolutions in 1 minute. Omega is 2 pi times the frequency. Frequency is the number of revolutions in 1 second. So in 1 second we have got omega over 2 pi, that is 4 divided by 2 pi, that is 2 by pi revolutions per second. Now, to find how much revolutions per minute, we have to multiply 60. So, revolutions per minute is 60 into revolutions per second. That is the frequency we got here, that is 2 divided by pi, which is 120 divided by pi. So, it is 120 divided by pi is around... I take 3, then it's 40. So because it's more than 3, it will be less than 30, 40. So it is 38.19 something revolutions per minute. So this is the answer to this question. Okay, thank you.